Welcome back to Michigan Matters, where we're now joined by two folks who are fighting the epidemic of illiteracy, and that would be Liza McFadden, president of the Barbara Bush Foundation for Family Literacy, which is in Florida and just expanded into Michigan, and Rob Tiede, who is helping the foundation's work here in Michigan. Good morning to you both. It's so great to have you here.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for having me.
Well, and Liza, thank you so much for coming all the way to Florida to be part of this whole conversation.
Absolutely.
So why is the Barbara Bush Foundation looking to help Michigan?
Well, first and foremost, Michigan has started the conversation. Reading Works has said, you know, there is an issue here in Michigan where people need to be able to read and need to have an opportunity to go back to school. And we want to embrace that and support it. You know, we look at it much like Angelina Jolie just came out recently and said she had a double mastectomy, and it's made the startling news. And right. 20 years ago, you couldn't go and have a conversation about breast cancer. And I would submit today, it's more difficult if you don't have a high school diploma to go to a cocktail party and say, I need to go back to school. And we want to change that. We want people to know they're welcome back to school. Education is a civil right, no matter your age. And so we want to be part of that conversation.
And I know Mrs. Bush has been a proponent of fighting for literacy and making sure people know how to read for many years, even before she was First Lady, in fact, when she was Vice President. And I know that even one of her sons, Neil, was dyslexic, and she first got into the battle from living her own experience with her son and helping him to get through this problem here. And Rob, I know you work in different industries here, but you're donating your time to help with this effort in Michigan. And why is this so important?
Well, it's important to me on a number of fronts. First and foremost, I think this is a very worthy cause. Mm-hmm. And I'm more than proud and privileged to contribute whatever time and contribute in other capacities. I'm proud to do whatever I can to help. But on the other hand, I've had a long-term friendship with the Bush family, and this is another way of not only making a positive impact and contribution to society, but also honoring a friendship, which is very near and dear to me, and propelling a cause that Mrs. Bush has spearheaded for nearly 25 years.
And in fact, speaking of the Bush family, you were here with George P. Bush, who is Jeb's oldest son. About a year and a half ago, he was part of the show. Michigan Matters came in, talked about his Maverick Pack, which he was starting at the time. You were helping him with that, trying to get more young people engaged in the Republican Party and all that. Is he involved as well in the Barbara Bush Foundation?
He is very much so, very much so.
In fact, isn't he involved with an upcoming event as well?
He does. He'll be hosting an event in Dallas called Celebration of Reading, and it's one of the three giant fundraisers we do across the country each year to raise money and awareness for family literacy. The funds go to support family literacy programs that we open. We've opened 1,200 across the United States in the last 24 years, one of them in Michigan this year, and checked before I came over here today. It's at Wayne Metro, 172 families on the waiting list. So
it tells you there's a huge need for it here.
A huge need, and huge interest. People love it.
Yeah, Mrs. Bush has been talking about this long before it was popular to talk about. It's been a problem, but a growing problem, which when you consider the amount of money that's spent on education, Liza, how do you explain the illiteracy epidemic that we seem to have?
Yeah, you know, it's really difficult and challenging, I think, if you're somebody who didn't finish high school for some reason and you want to go back. Sometimes there's a challenge because your other peers haven't gone back. And part of what we want to do is say, you know what, you can go back to school, and not only can you do it, but you can help your children to do it. So one of the first things that we're going to be doing in Michigan is working with the First Lady's office. And Rob, do you want to talk a little bit about
that? Yes, that's going to be, it's something we're very, very proud of. We're very energized about this. It's going to be our first initiative into the state of Michigan, this Love, Read, Learn baby
journal. It's an actual booklet, isn't it, that you're going to be making available?
It's an actual product, which will be available after the art contest commences next fall. It will become available through hospitals to all new Michigan mothers. And we're just absolutely delighted and thrilled that, of course, Mrs. Snyder would take on a leadership role in that document.
And actually, it encourages parents and moms and dads and grandparents and others to read to little ones to try to avoid this problem, correct?
Yes, absolutely. I think what we've been witnessing here and in other locations is a multi-generational erosion, and we want to curtail that now, and we want to ensure that all people have, you know, their dreams are their limits, right? Mrs. Bush has said, you know, the opportunities of a great education are limitless or unlimited. And we very much believe in that each and every day.
And I know that Jeb Bush, who is Mrs. Bush's son, along with Doro Bush, who is another one, the daughter, mm-hmm. are now co-chairing the organization, correct? Mrs. Bush is still involved, though, right?
Correct. She is honorary chair. But I will tell you that a week doesn't go by where she's not engaged in some way, Skyping to classrooms or visiting children and adults in hospitals to read with them. So she remains very engaged at the young age of 80, almost 88 next week.
We should all be so blessed to be that active at 88 years old.
Absolutely.
Well, I know there's a lot more to say, and we're going to continue the conversation. In fact, we're going to move to the round table, and one more person, Carol Goss, the Skillman Foundation, is going to be joining us in the conversation, so keep it right here.